Clean up your life. A breakup signifies a new beginning. Therefore, cleaning and organizing your personal space will leave you feeling refreshed and prepared for the new things to come. A mess can be incredibly overwhelming and depressing. Plus, it'll only add to your stress level. So don't live in one. The added bonus of cleaning up is that keeping busy with tidying your space doesn't require a lot of brain power, but does require just enough focus to keep you from recycling your pain and thinking about your ex. Find happiness in other areas of your life. A relationship is just one part of your life, but there are personal pleasures that you can and should enjoy on your own. You should have been spending time by yourself even when you weren't single, but this time try to find something new, something that you always wanted to do, but never did for whatever reason. Indulge in those things now. Some people say that the best revenge is living well. So enjoy being single. It'll give off the signal that you're healthy in body and in mind. And someone will eventually notice just how awesome your life is. And you never know, they might want to become a part of it. It's very important to stay active, even if you're not trying to get over a breakup. Exercise improves your mood and alleviates depression. Plus, it's a good distraction to get your mind off the situation. If you don't exercise regularly, here are a few good ways you can motivate yourself. Try doing something small. Going all the way to the gym or getting decked out in your jogging gear obviously seems like too much work for some people. So just do 10 push-ups or sit-ups or squats. Anything really. It just has to be a small effort. Usually, that's enough to get your heart rate going a little bit. And it makes you feel like just a little bit more exercise wouldn't be so bad. Another funny thing that I personally try is to meet yourself halfway. If you usually walk to the gym, then drive there. Or if you really want to go to the gym but you just don't feel like it, then make a deal with yourself that you'll go there, and if you still don't feel like working out, you'll go home. Odds are that once you're there, you won't feel like going home. But if you do, that's okay too. Tell yourself you'll just walk on the treadmill for 10 minutes, even if your exercise routine involves a lot more. Just telling yourself you'll do one more thing without having to commit to anything else will make things much easier. And before long, your endorphins will take over. You'll probably even end up doing the full workout before you know it. Get a hobby. If you already have a hobby, get a new one. Something time-consuming that won't allow you to sit in the house all day thinking about the whys and the what-ifs. Or if you don't want to go outside, find something that involves a lot of physical or mental focus. That way, you won't be able to think about your ex and feel the pain over and over and over again. The most important thing to have is fun, so that you'll want to repeat the process. The point is to let yourself get carried away, so you don't constantly remind yourself that you started the hobby just to forget about your ex. Do anything you can to make yourself feel desirable. Get a haircut or add highlights. Buy a new outfit. Quit smoking. Remember all those times that your ex told you were the most beautiful person in the world. Convince yourself that they were right. That's indeed true. And someone else will come along who will appreciate you the way that they once did. Especially now after your new makeover. Use your breakup as an opportunity to become the person you've always wanted to be. Take on a daunting goal, such as learning a new language, instrument, or skill. There has never been a better time to set those goals in motion, and now you have a lot more time to do it. Don't listen to the saddest love songs you can think of. Sad songs just make you think of what went wrong, and it's a lot harder to move on when all you're thinking about are the lyrics of a sad song you relate to. I know sometimes it helps to listen to music that matches your feelings because you have stored up grief that needs a trigger to help you release it. But beware of wallowing. After a certain point, you're no longer helping yourself by going through it over and over again with sad songs. Instead, try making playlists that put your thoughts where you want them to be. Make a collection of self-affirming, new attitude songs if you're feeling helpless. If your ex has left you for another person, then that should make everything a lot easier for you. They didn't appreciate what they had. If he or she came back to you and said that they wanted to start things over, would you really want to take them back? Would you be able to trust them again? Even if the answer is yes, or maybe, you shouldn't take that chance. Because some people who cheat and get forgiven, cheat again. It's time to find somebody new. Someone who will be easier to trust and won't fill your heart with anxiety every time they're late. Don't keep in touch with your ex. At least not until you're both ready. Even if you and your ex have decided to stay friends, break away completely immediately after the breakup. This means not seeing each other, not being around their family, not being around mutual friends, no phone calls, no emails, no text messages, and no instant messages. Facebook is no exception either. Remember, this doesn't have to be forever if you don't want it to be. Lots of people can stay friends with their exes and be purely platonic. But until you can feel that way without an ulterior motive, you're only hurting yourself. Of course, you might be in a kind of situation where you have to come into contact with them in order to deal with practical aspects of things like moving out, exchanging property, or signing papers. But try to limit this to what's absolutely necessary, and then keep such meetings short and civil. Be polite, but not too polite. You know what I mean. It's very easy to get caught up in the moment, but believe me, that'll only make things worse. If you find yourself compulsively checking your ex's Facebook or any other social networking profile, help yourself out and use a program or a browser extension to block the URL of that profile. It also helps to take them off your friend list. Even if things ended on a clean slate, it can be too painful or uncomfortable to see what they're up to. Don't find an excuse to ask them about any situation. This will only hurt you in the end and will eventually start to look like you're begging for them back. You're giving them the power. And then you're helplessly waiting for a response that you might never get. If you're not strong enough to do these things, then the bare minimum that you can do is to change your settings so that you're not notified every single time they update something. Sitting opposite the screen looking at a recent happy picture of your ex and their new girlfriend or boyfriend is not going to be very pleasant. So don't put yourself through that. No stalking, cyber or otherwise. Come on, guys, that's a serious offense. If they don't already have one, don't give them a legal case against you, or they might be pushed to get a restraining order. If you know their passwords to their email, Facebook, or whatever, resist the temptation to go into their accounts. And if they have your passwords, change them immediately. Also, having mutual friends tell you everything they're doing is not only creepy, but it'll make things worse. Believe me, you don't need to know. Sometimes you don't even want to know. You simply need to let it be and have some self-respect. But most of all, you need to have respect for that person. Whatever they did to you, they still deserve their privacy. This one is very, very important. Do not hook up with your ex at all. That's a no-brainer, guys. You will start right back at square one, and all the work you did trying to get over them will have gone to waste. Now you just passed step 26, and with only 4 to go, you go and do something that stupid? Come on, guys, don't disappoint me. Don't take anything your ex ever said or did personally, because nothing your ex said or did was ever about you. Even if they downright blame you for everything that happened, realize that that statement is only coming from who they are, which has absolutely nothing to do with the person that you are. Of course, if you know that some of those statements are true, thank them for opening your eyes, and then do everything in your power to fix it and become a better person. But don't do it so they can see that you've changed, and then go beg for them back. Because even if you got back together, there will always be certain triggers that turn you both into who you used to be. So do it for you, so you can be a better boyfriend or girlfriend to the next person who comes along. Now this is going to be very hard, but bear with me, it's the second last step. Pray for your ex every day. Pray that they'll be granted all the love, wealth, health, and happiness that you pray for yourself. Even if you're not that religious, or if you don't believe in God, the act in itself is liberating. In 12-step programs, such as Alcoholics Anonymous, they're taught to pray for people they have a deep resentment towards. I know that, in the beginning, you won't mean a word of the prayer. But if you say the prayer constantly for a couple of weeks, you will eventually come to genuinely meaning it, and find that there is a part of you that realizes that your ex is just a human being with their own imperfections, weaknesses, and shortcomings. If you go deeper, you'll realize that they may also be as hurt as you are. Even if they outwardly seem like a very hostile, aggressive, and manipulative person. Of course, no matter what happened to them in their childhood or day-to-day life, that does not give them a reason to mistreat you. But by being aware of the fact that your ex has their own set of issues to deal with, it'll help you replace the hurt and anger that you feel with compassion and understanding. Well, you came this far, so it's time for the last step. You ready? Forgive your ex, no matter what they did or didn't do. Unfortunately, it's not enough to just say, I forgive you, and leave it at that. However, if you've successfully ticked off all of the above steps, then you've undoubtedly reached a point where you know that what happened happened for a good reason, that it was ultimately for the best, and that even if your ex seems like a bad person, they're really not. The breakup made you a better person and led you to fixing all those other things in your life. It may sound strange, but you actually owe them a big thank you. So if you know all this, it's going to be very easy to feel like everything is okay and finally forgive them. A word of the wise, make sure you don't rush through any of these steps. I know it seems like a long list, But believe me when I say that it'll be more time-consuming if you rush through the steps, and then keep going back and forth through them. It'll be a lot faster if you just give each of them the appropriate time, and slowly but surely cross them off the list. By the time you reach the last one, I'm sure you'll not only be over your ex, but you will be so much better a person that you will start to attract even better new people into your life. Patience pays, people. Kaleme.